get you sailing right now. Ooh. I got too much on my mind right now. Tell that girl, Rodeo, get my baby 30,000. Bar for me. Bar for me, yeah. Bar for me. Bar for me, yeah. Bar for me.
Money back.
I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up it, I'ma squeeze. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. Got it. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef.
All right, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Carolina Panthers. Two teams here fresh off week one victories. Who can keep it going as we're underway on EA Sports? And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. On first and 10, Bridgewater. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Second down, McCaffrey. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
On third down, Bridgewater going deep for Hopkins, and he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Fielded at the 20. We'll call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. First down, Winston. And incomplete to open things up. He was looking for Chris Godwin that time. That'll bring up second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Second down, Winston again. Out to the left there, complete to Howard. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead him to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Winston now to throw on first down. And Winston lost the football. But it looks like a Buccaneer was able to corral it. Yes, the Bucs have it. Tampa Bay keeps the possession. But call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. They don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you retain possession, that's all you're looking for.
Winston. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Jameis to throw it. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They get 15, but they still needed a little bit more. Fourth down. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. Needing the tough yards, they run into their fullback. And this will depend on the mark. I'm not sure he pushed the line forward. And indeed, he did not. They stop him. So just shy of midfield, they tried it. Didn't work out. What did you think?
I thought that they should have punted the ball away. Should have gotten rid of it and played defense with better field position. Look, I'm as aggressive as anyone wanting to go for it on offense. But in this situation, it doesn't.
First half.
I don't know that there's any risk. I mean, what's the reward for your risk here? I would not have done that. My only explanation is for this coach. He may want to be up here in the booth with us. We may have a 3-man booth starting next week if he keeps up with those decisions.
Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him. And some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
This is McCaffrey on the give. He'll get about 4 here, down to the 43-yard line.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
And the Bucs with an extra defender in the secondary now on 3rd down.
5 down.
50. From the gun, Bridgewater. And he finds a man. It's McCaffrey. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. On first down. This is McCaffrey. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Get set.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. Forward to the 29-yard line. It'll only be a gain of a yard, and it sets up a third down at 4 now. Shotgun. It's Bridgewater. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. First target, first catch, and a first down. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
And they'll go on the run. He'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. The Panthers on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Being chased out left. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. It's a gain of 3, and it gets him the first. Take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. A gain of 3, second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
Shift.
intercepted, of course, and that moves him back five. A second down throw for Bridgewater. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. The Panthers on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is going to be third and 13. Here's Bridgewater. That's complete to McCaffrey. And certainly some style points there on the spin. Not a whole lot thereafter, but still a pretty good gain. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to make it fourth down. Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for 3. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And this one is right through. And the Panthers stake claim to a 3-0 lead. So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays? You don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3. But this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
So they saw the contact before the ball arrived. Penalty flag for pass interference.
And trying to avoid pass interference is so difficult. You're trying to slow down these skilled receivers, and somehow, some way, they make plays on the football, and sometimes you're there too soon.
Ready! Blue way!
After the penalty, it's Mixon. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Two minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. On 2nd down, here's Mixon. Room here to run. Look at the spin. Bout touchdown, Tampa Bay. A great play there. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs are able to strike for 6. Heck of a start to his season. He had 2 touchdowns in the opener last week, another one here in week 2.
Well, I don't want to call him a touchdown machine this early, but sometimes you get locked in, you know, and you feel good about things. You get into that zone, and those touchdowns come in bunches. He may be off to that kind of a start.
It's like he was shot out of a cannon. I would imagine success this early, great momentum going forward for the rest of the year.
He keeps this up, they'll soon be chanting MVP anytime he touches the ball.
Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This one taken from the 7. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
Five down, five down.
Single, 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 single.
No, 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 no.
They go play action here on first down. Got a man open. It's Ricky Seals-Jones. He's at the 30. Pass for 20. And oh, at the end of it, he's stripped. Ball comes loose. And the Buccaneers have it.
It's not often that we see big plays end in disaster. And we just absolutely saw it right there. They had something really big cooking on that one.
Can you, when you're down near the goal line like that on a big play, do you get maybe a little too careless, a little too desperate for the goal line?
I think the last part is exactly right. You get desperate for the goal line, and sometimes you get the ball out of him away from your body, or you're trying to extend to get there, or maybe you're just trying so hard that the ball will come out of your hands. In any event, that's a big opportunity lost.
So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. They'll try to run with McCaffrey, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
He'll get it up the middle. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness. Think about running the ball here, not even a thought, is
it? Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Get wide, man. Fire down, fire down.
Check 37.
Third and goal for Bridgewater. He can run for it, and he will. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards that time out of the scramble, but now they're looking at a fourth down situation. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage three here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
So we're back to a one-point game now as the kickoff comes. Short, short kick. One of the up middle take it now. So a very tight first half. We had to break in a one-point game. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The Bucs with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had an ability to see what you've done, they're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26.
Hey, 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 hey. Four down, four down, four down. Sonny!
Second down, Winston. Floating one, incomplete. The all-pro linebacker Luke Kuechly right there on the coverage, stride for stride.
Well, sometimes you just have to take things into your own hands, don't you? I mean, the offense is really struggling in this game. They're the ones keeping things going. They have to continue to play at that level.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave them trying to convert on third and nine. From the shotgun, it's Winston. And he's got Rodgers. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28. He sets to fire deep. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
But depending on the team, they call that an explosive play or a chunk play, the one that they got on the previous one. They tried to go back and get another one, didn't they?
They did, but unsuccessful on that second attempt. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten.
Let's convert.
They'll run it now out of the gun. So we got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Bucs on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and seven.
Ready. Move away.
Working out of the gun. Winston. Flushed out right. The 20. And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard complete. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. O.J. Howard, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead. Now Sturgis on to add the extra point. Sturgis for the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This one taken from the 7. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Now a play fake here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Chalk that up as their first sack in this game, and they tallied 4 a week ago.
And probably not as much exultation in that sack as what took us so long. Because when you get 4 the previous week, you're counting on continuing that momentum. They didn't get that done in the first half of the game. Let's see now if they start to bring even more exotic pressure towards the quarterback.
Snap.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. On play action, it's Bridgewater. Out to his left. Excellent work that time to get free, and for his exploits, he's going to be left with just a third and three. I thought they were going to sack him there like they did on first down. Great coverage, but he found a way to move with his legs.
Yeah, his ability to take off, not only did he get some yardage back, he got a little bit extra. Really helps him on third down, makes it manageable now.
The Panthers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This time it's third and three. Throwing, Bridgewater. The kicker here is complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. 46. They'll run with McCaffrey. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Second down, Bridgewater. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler DeAndre Hopkins, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. Just his second incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
The Panthers on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This is third and 7. Bridgewater to throw it. Caught left side, Hopkins. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on 4th. Off the play fake, Bridgewater taking a shot for Samuel. That's going to be caught. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. He's going to get it running right. And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina. A great effort there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Panthers are a 2-point conversion away from tying up this football game. Ron Rivera didn't get the nickname Riverboat Ron for nothing. His guys are going to go for two here.
This certainly feels like they were wanting to go for two, but weren't really sure they should go for two. Do we, don't we, do we, don't we? And guess what ends up happening?
5-yard penalty.
That's right. Now you probably line up and kick the extra point.
A try here for the extra point. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is cut to one at 14-13. So we're back to a one-point game now as the kickoff comes. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Buccaneer offense gets set to take over. They were able to extend their lead with an opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter, but that just got matched a moment ago.
So we know that what they discussed at the half worked. Now, what are the counters to that, right? You don't just run the same things over and over. Some do, but many will also show something and then come back with something else to keep the defense off balance.
Jameis now on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Here's a give to Mixon. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard. And we're back now in Charlotte. And we've got a dandy here. One-point game as we begin the fourth. The offense on third down tonight, they've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They failed once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. They run for it with Mixon. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. They're able to... Keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Ready. Blue wave.
They try to eat some clock with Mixon. Taking it right down Broadway. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one good for 33 and a first.
And that's the type of run that they're looking for, because they'll need to continue to rely on him to move the sticks in this tight game in order to preserve this lead.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Rashard on the toss. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. A great play there. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Sturgis adds the PAT. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Steps away to his left. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Quan Alexander able to run him down for a loss of a yard. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
After the sack here, second and 11. Pitching it out to McCaffrey. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go. Two-point conversion away from tying up this football game. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest...
And he's going to be grabbed and pulled down. And the failure to convert and tie the game, now the pressure shifts back to the defense.
But I think it was the right play. I think it was the right call to try and tie the game there. Kick an extra point, you're still down one. What's the sense? I like what they did.
It's
So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. This one taken from the seven. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your four-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. And remember, the four-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs to make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
He finds Howard complete. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching Atlanta, our apologies. Jameis now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll go as a loss of 5, and it'll be a second and long. Winston. Oh, he's able to out-muscle him here as he pulls it in. That his first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Ready, flat, 22. Let's convert.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8.
Ready.
Again, it's Mixon. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. The Bucs on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7.
Ready. Blue lady.
They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave them with a 4th down. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Thomas Morstead now.
as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Carolina getting set to take the field. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. He'll look to throw. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
Well, how about keeping your head about you in this situation? No more timeouts. Finds a way to get out of bounds. Now they can breathe a little bit as they contemplate what to do on the next down.
This quarterback now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now a toss. This is McCaffrey. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here. He's back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by MJ Stewart. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the two-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They're looking to throw this. Winston, he's got his tight end over the middle, O.J. Howard. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. A big game there, and that should certainly be enough to put this one in the win column. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Sturgis for the extra point, and it might seal the deal as that makes it a two-score game here with not a lot of time remaining. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
Now Bridgewater. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that's caught at the 25. A big play there for Carolina. 51 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
Well, Charles, it's great to win at home in the NFL. When you win on the road, it's a little extra special.